New developments on the Israel-Hamas war tonight. The last known Canadian believed to be held hostage by Hamas has been confirmed dead by her family. A relative says 70-year-old Judy Weinstein Haggai did not survive following the October 7th attack in their community. Jason Guidola joins us live in studio tonight with the very latest. Good evening, Jason.
Yeah, good evening, Taz. This comes just days after her husband, Gadi Haggai, was also confirmed dead by her family. The family adds that both of them were on an early morning walk on October 7th, right at the time when Hamas crossed the border into Israel, killing 1,200 people and kidnapping 240 others. Among the limited details, we do know so far that earlier this month, relatives say through a text message, Weinstein Haggai told others that her husband was shot and killed by Hamas militant on a motorcycle, and she was also wounded. The community tried to dispatch an ambulance, but couldn't do so because of Hamas's presence. Her family adds Israeli forces detected her cell phone signal in Gaza at a later date. The English teacher was born in New York State, but moved to Toronto at the age of three, then moved to Israel 20 years later to live with her husband. Weinstein Haggai was also known to help Palestinians in Gaza, a territory under humanitarian crisis and with a death toll of more than 20,000 people since the start of the war. Meanwhile, Israeli forces have been reportedly detaining many in Gaza, including a video circulating online showing Palestinian men and children stripped and detained by soldiers.
With all due respect to those videos, even if those people will get arrested, they will be arrested in Israel, they will go to court, they will see a lawyer. What about our hostages? Even the Red Cross haven't visited them for almost 3 months. So I'm not disturbed by those videos. We have no intention to arrest innocent children. But sometimes Hamas will use those children to transfer explosives, to target the IDF troops in Gaza. So when we have no choice, yes, we will detain minors and we will treat them properly. We are not eager to do it, but we know that Hamas will use women and children in order to attack us.
And staying with the war, Israeli forces are urging Gazans who fled from the north to the central part of the region to evacuate shelters there after there were airstrikes that reportedly killed at least 50 people. Also, the U.S. Secretary of State is expected to be in Israel next week to discuss further war strategy.